Hello everybody, my name is Vinay Jacob John. Please visit my gospel website jesushealsministries.org. Today we're going to read from the Holy Bible about the resurrection of the dead in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Romans chapter 6 verses 1 to 23. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? God forbid. How shall we that are dead to sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with Jesus by baptism into death, that like as Christ Jesus was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, Jehovah, the Holy Spirit, even so we also should walk in newness of life. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also of resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with Jesus, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Now if we be dead with Jesus Christ, we believe that we shall also live with Jesus Christ. Knowing that Christ Jesus, being raised from the dead, died no more. Death has no more dominion over you, Jesus. For in that you died, Jesus, you died unto sin once, but in that you live unto God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit. Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body, that ye should obey it in the lust thereof, neither yield ye your members as instruments of unrighteousness unto sin, but yield yourselves unto God as those that are alive from the dead, and your members instruments of righteousness unto God. For sin shall not have dominion over you, for ye are not under the law, but under grace. What then? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? God forbid. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his masters ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. But God be thanked that ye were the servants of sin, but ye have obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine which has delivered you. Being then made free from sin, ye became the servants of righteousness. Even so now yield your members servants to righteousness unto holiness. For when ye were the servants of sin, ye were free from righteousness. What fruit have ye then in those things whereof ye are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death. But now, being made free from sin, and become servants to God, ye have your fruit unto holiness, and the end everlasting life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, Jehovah, is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. Also, John chapter 11, verse 23. Jesus saith unto her, thy brother shall rise again. Martha saith unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believe thou this? She said unto him, Yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Son of God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ, which should come into the world. Verse 39, Jesus said, Take ye away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, saith unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he hath been dead 4 days. Verse 40, Jesus saith unto her, Said I not unto thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Then they took away the stone where the dead was laid, and Jesus lifted up eyes and said, Father Jehovah, I thank thee that thou hast heard me, and I knew that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. And when he thus had spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face was bound about with a napkin. Jesus saith unto them, Loose him and let him go. Verse 45. Then many of the Jews which came to Mary and had seen the things which Jesus did, believed in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And also, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also who sleep, or who are dead in Jesus Christ, will God, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, Jehovah bring with Jesus. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord Jesus, that we which are alive, remaining unto the coming of our Lord Jesus, shall not prevent them which are asleep or dead. For the Lord Jesus himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ Jesus shall rise first. Then we which are alive, remaining, shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord Jesus in the air, and so shall we ever be with our Lord Jesus Christ, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit. Therefore, comfort one another with these words. Thank you for listening to me today. Jesus loves us all. Jesus heals us all. Jesus provides for us all. Always. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.